Okay, so this is the easiest of the two trigonometry questions. Question number 5. We have a very typical right triangle here. A, B, C, these are the edges of this triangle, and we have the angle alpha here. Given value of B, so this is something we know, and sine alpha, so this is the sine of this angle, is also something that we know. Find the values, in this case formulas for A and C. Why it specifically asks for formulas? Because I would prefer you to start with symbolic mathematics, symbolic calculation, not starting already with numbers. Okay, but it's not that bad working with formulas, and I will try to convince you that it is not that that difficult. So we have sine alpha, and we have the value of adjacent, which is B in this case. We know sine alpha and B, so why not to put down a formula for sine alpha? Sine alpha is unfortunately not the adjacent, the opposite, A divided by hypotenuse by C. And we have a problem. We know we are given the value of sine alpha. Okay, well, later on in the last stage of this exercise we will use the value of sine alpha 0.6, but not yet now. Okay, but we don't know A and we don't know C. Actually this question asks us to provide the formulas for both A and C. One thing that we can spot here, I have one equation here, two unknowns, so something is wrong about it. If you have a situation like this, one equation, too many unknowns, but two possible ways of resolving the situation. Mathematically, very technically, it's just one way. You have to find another equation. Okay, so one way is, if I have one equation, two unknown, I have to find another equation. Okay, with two equations, two unknowns, I can solve the problem. Right, but I can also think a little bit differently and just think, okay, if this is a nasty problem, okay, I have sine and I have B, and they don't fit each to other, okay, they don't fit together. What if I had, let's say, okay, I just have a moment for fantasies. What if I had cosine instead of sine? Okay, if I had the cosine alpha is the adjacent B over hypotenuse over C. Oh, this would be lovely, wouldn't it? If I knew cosine alpha, I know B, and I would have just one unknown. Just C is something that I don't know in this exercise. Okay, but the truth is, unfortunately, I have sine alpha and not cosine alpha. So what can I do? Can you propose something? How can I change this exercise, this question, so that I could use the formula for cosine? You already know, so I won't ask you for the answer. But
can you use the sine squared alpha plus cosine?
Sorry? Equals one, yes, so-called trigonometrical identity. This is a very famous and incredibly useful formula, which says that sine squared alpha plus cosine squared alpha equals one. Okay? If I know sine alpha, I can very easily find cosine alpha from this, because sorting now unknowns on one side, knowns on the other side, I will leave my unknown cosine on this side. So it's cosine squared alpha equals 1 minus sine squared alpha. Okay, I have cosine here, it's still squared. Okay, so to find cosine alpha, I need to put it into a square root. And that's the first step. This is actually, this question didn't ask me about cosine alpha, So it's something I calculated extra. But this means that I can forget about this formula, okay? Even if it was correct, okay? But I can now use this formula. In this formula, I know cosine alpha because this is something like that, okay? I know b because it was given, and I need to look for c, okay? I will do it very, very slowly, step by step. Actually, you can just, if you have that level of experience in mathematics, you can just starting right c equals something. Half of you already know. You already know the solution, but I will do it very, very, very slowly. I have a nasty division here. I want to get rid of this division because divisions are not very easy to process in equations. So I will multiply both sides by c. If I multiply both sides of this equation by c, on the left-hand side, I will get c times cosine alpha, and on the right hand side, b divided by c multiplied by c is simply b. Okay, very good, but b is not anything I would be looking for. I'm looking for c, but now I can divide both sides by c. Sorry, not by c, it wouldn't give me anything. By cosine alpha, so c multiplied by cosine alpha, divided by cosine alpha, gives me just c here, and on the other hand, the other side, I have b divided by cosine alpha, and that's the solution. I know the cosine alpha from this formula. I can be very correct here, but actually, you will not lose your mark if you just leave it as it is now, because I can easily find the cosine from this formula. So it may be the end of this part of the exercise. However, one thing that I will ask you to do, always put either a frame around or just underline your solutions, okay? So here we have a clear underlining of this cosine alpha, or even putting into a frame cosine alpha and c. We could go slightly farther and say that c equals b. This is a easy to apply mathematical technique called substitution. If I know the value of cosine alpha, I can take this value and substitute the existing symbol for cosine alpha in my equation by something I know it's equal to cosine alpha. So that is this. In this question, they also ask us for the value of A. Okay, find the values of A and C. So far we have found C. How can we find A? What we can use to find A? Who might tell me? A, anyone? Calculate A? So it's Pythagorean. So either from Pythagorean, we know that c squared equals a squared plus b squared. Okay, that's one quite obvious solution, and very good, all right? So going this way, we need a. So a squared equals c squared minus b squared. So a is square root of c squared minus b squared, okay? The only thing that I don't like very much in this solution, if I had to do it, okay, would be there are so many squares here and even a square root. It's not that easy to actually solve. So let's try to do it. This is good, okay? This is good, and this would make a solution. We can also say again, say sorry to this formula here, say hello to this formula. This is what we are going to use right now, because we know the value of sine alpha, we know the value of c now, and we are looking for the value of a. So I will use this area here to, first of all, derive this formula, sine alpha equals a over c. I will multiply both sides by C, and and I will swap them around, so I can directly write this formula for A. A equals C sine alpha. Okay, it will be a little bit easier to calculate, and the calculation is the next step, because the next step of this exercise is, once you provide the formulas, follow on with the calculations for B equals 10 and sine alpha equals 0.6. So we have now B equals 10 and sine alpha equals 0.6.